everyone. Welcome aboard. Listen, you're in for a real treat. I brought with me my infrared camera once again, and you'll see multiple clips. I'll even take the filter off and show you a comparison. You'll be amazed at how that infrared technology works. You can see through a lot of haze. It is unbelievable. I tell you, I'll be zooming in to the horizon and it just left me speechless. I don't know what to think about this flat earth, but I tell you, this infrared footage is starting to make a believer out of me. Just simply incredible. I won't be doing any analysis like in my previous clip. I'll leave that for another video. And so here, just enjoy these clips, these multiple sequences from different points along the flight. Just take it all in. It is incredible. I'll try to narrate as we go along. What you see here, we just took off and there's this marine layer. We're over the water. Of course it extends inland. And, we just left Los Angeles on the way to Dulles. In a short while, we'll be in Baker. Just about. Now here we are, and Pahrump is to the right, there's a mountain range as Mount Charles to this valley to the left, and I brought my phone with the GPS app, and we've leveled off at about 32,000 feet. So on this map, I'm showing the flight path. And the black line is the distance measured out to a mountain range way in the distance. You'll see it in the clip. It's about 200 miles. There's Mount Charleston clearly visible. And we'll even see Groom Lake, the location of the famous Area 51. Yeah, it's really incredible. So this is my infrared filter. It's a 950 nanometer long pass infrared filter. Blocks visible and lets infrared through, basically. I'll be putting that on the front of the camera, and then I'll switch the camera to night shot. You'll be amazed, just watch. Wow, look at that. Isn't that incredible? This green tint is default and I cannot change it, but in Photoshop or actually Premiere, Adobe Premiere, I'll be changing it. So this looks much better. Desaturated the clip and adjusting contrast. And you'll see me adjusting contrast throughout the clips. Foreground, this mountain is Mount Charleston. Behind it is the Nevada test site. Now you can see Groom Lake and Papoose Lake to the left. Just incredible. Look at that. The mountain range in the back, I identified on the map at about 200 miles out. Look at that. Just take it all in. This is incredible. Just incredible. That banding. The atmosphere, something else, isn't it? Just look at that, look how far we can see. foreground, that's Las Vegas right there. That strip is to the right. That's the Paramount Valley, I guess. And now Charleston. Now, this is what it looks like in Invisible. Looking out the window, lots of haze. And you'll see here, camera to night shot mode, then I'll put the infrared filter on. See how it clarifies. Here we go. Look at that. And then I'll be adjusting the saturation and contrast. Ah, much better. In the foreground, we see Lake. Look at that. Wow. Here I just adjusted contrast again. Isn't that incredible? Just the camera I'm using is a Sony HDR AX53. It can zoom out about 30x. Just a great camera. It has the night shot capability, which is why I bought it. I'm very pleased with it. Just look at this imagery and infrared. Just incredible. Here you can faintly see some mountain ranges way in the distance. Adjusting contrast really helps you. Look at that. Can you see that? You know, this imagery really doesn't compare with what NASA is showing in their infrared images. The surface just doesn't have the curvature they show. You know? It's like, are they misrepresenting the curvature? I don't know, this footage is really, really incredible. It's making me kind of rethink stuff. You know? I don't want to say the Earth is flat, but man, it's flat as phenomena. There's a phenomena here that lets us see way in the distance. And we need to figure out why that is. That's the Grand Canyon. Yeah, look at that. There's a mountain range way out there. I just adjusted contrast and I'm zooming in more on that. Just look at that. Oh my goodness, just look at that. Wow. Just wow, you know. Wow. And I have goosebumps. What does this mean? You know, our bloop theory explains so much. It's like, we don't want to throw that out either. Seems like there's two realities. We look up and the motion of the planets, the sun, moon, stars lead us to believe we're part of an infinite universe in the solar system. And that's what the supernatural beings want us to believe if we're captive inside of this dome. Because when we look down, it appears we're in a flat world. Everybody's gotta make up their own mind, but this is strange. Anyway, I hope you guys have enjoyed these infrared video clips. They're really incredible. So what does all this mean, folks? I'm gonna leave you with this image here extracted from the clips, you know? Are there two realities when we look up, you know? Are we led to believe we're in a solar system? Yet when we look down, it appears we're on a flat Earth model. I mean, if the Almighty put us in some sort of a, you know, enclosure and built a firmament, you know, anybody that can build such an extensive firmament, if you will, you know, they wouldn't be building a shabby, you know, backdrop, you know, painted or something. It could be something, you know, really futuristic, a holographic backdrop with even, you know, asteroids and meteors thrown in or comets. I mean, you know, it could be something really fancy, you know. You know, philosophically, I have kind of hard time believing that puts God in a bad light, as if he's trying to deceive us in a way. Kind of like the infinite universe, but I don't know, there's philosophical questions here. But for right now, I'm thinking maybe when we look up, we're led to believe one thing, so we have one model for that. And when we look down, it appears we're on a flat surface, you know. So anyway, something to think about, you know. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys.